गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू स्टैंडर्ड 6 SST पार्ट 2 ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 3 मैप्स. ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन एट पेज नंबर 107. वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर. एंड टुडे I will teach you maps based on content. Okay, children. Hope you all are get ready with your book and pencil. And don't forget to underline the important things. Maps based on content. We can broadly classify maps into three major groups based on their content or purpose: physical maps, political maps, and thematic maps. Maps are provided with suitable titles according to the information contained in it. Now we'll see what is physical maps. Physical maps are those that represent the physical or natural features of the earth's surface, such as the relief map of any country, vegetation map, soil map, or land use. In these maps, the geographical features are important, not their boundaries. So, in a physical map of the world, you may or you may not see the boundaries of different countries or states. Next, we'll see weather maps. Weather maps show the movement of weather system, the distribution of rainfall or snowfall, areas of equal temperature or air pressure, or even wind direction. Thirdly, we'll see topographical maps. Topographical maps show great details of the natural features of a small area, including rivers, lakes, mountains, etc., along with man-made features like parks, wells, cities, and towns. Thematic maps. What is thematic maps, children? The maps can also show types of soil, forest areas, the distribution of minerals and industries in an area. Such maps, which are based on a theme or a topic, are called thematic maps. Okay, children, now turn the page. Next, we will see political maps. Political maps show the political boundaries of the countries, states, districts, cities, villages, or towns, with the help of lines to show borders or boundaries. Okay, next, we'll see distribution maps. Distribution maps show the distribution of crops, minerals, and forests. B. Nautical maps or charts. Nautical maps are used to navigate ships. They show details of the shorelines and islands, as well as depth of water, hazards like rocks, location of lighthouses, and see. Next, we'll see aviation maps or charts. Aviation charts show airways, traffic control towers, airports, and air routes. D. Geographical maps. Geographical maps show the edges and types of rock and soil. Tourist maps point to places of interest, museums, monuments, etc., in a particular area. Next, we'll see limitations of maps. Since curved surface of the earth is represented on a flat surface on a maps, a problem arises. A round shape cannot be flattened completely. Next, we'll see atlas. As told earlier, an atlas is a book or collection of maps, usually bound together in a book. Besides maps of the world, selected continents and countries, it may include information and diagrams related to geographical features and population data. Sketch. A diagram which is drawn without taking into consideration the actual distance between places or direction is called a sketch. The important landmarks such as hospitals, shops, offices, ponds, bridges, etc. can be marked on it. Thus, in a sketch, no scale, signs or symbols are used. Plans. A plan is an outline drawing of a building or a room or a small area, such as a market or a housing complex or even a classroom. The plan includes the direction, symbols and distance accurately, much like a map. But a map represents a vast area and does not show minor details, whereas plans represent a small area and show minor details. Children, now here the chapter is over. So you do one thing, you underline these important things, the underlined sentences you write down, the important things you write down in this geography copy, and learn and read this chapter again and again for better understanding. Okay, bye bye.